Hi, I'm John with Behringer, and welcome to Music Group Studios. In this quick tip video, I'd like to talk a bit about the monitor bus on the X32 family of digital consoles. What the monitor bus is basically the signal that's going to feed your headphones or your control room outputs, which is going to feed a cue edge or in the studio, your studio monitors. Now you want this signal to be a little bit different than your main left right because, for example, soloing. If you're soloing something in your headphones, of course, you don't want that to affect the mix that your audience is listening to. So there's quite a few settings we have for our monitor bus on the X32, so let's have a look. To get there, we're just going to press the view button by your monitor controls. First thing you see here on the page is we have a number of soloing options here that you can affect how the solo system works. So you have exclusive, for example, where you can only solo one channel at a time. And if you solo another channel, it'll unsolo the other one. And actually, if you scroll through these pages, the console will even tell you what the different options do. One of my favorites is use master fader. It's great for when you have a monitor console scenario. When you engage that, it'll actually switch your master fader to control the solo bus, which is great because usually if you're only using it as a monitor console, you don't need to control the left right anyway. But yeah, there's a number of options here, and again, the console kind of explains that to you right on the page. We also have a delay option, and this can be handy when you're using headphones in a live scenario. Say you're 250 feet away from the stage, you can actually delay your headphones a little bit so that that sound aligns with what you're hearing from the stage in the background. It's pretty handy to have. Next, you have a dim control, so you can basically set up how the dim works. We have a dedicated dim button on the console here, so you can set that up. And we also have a mono and a trim control. Finally, you can change the monitor source. There's a few options here for what you want the monitor bus to output. For example, do you want the left-right feed to be PFL, pre-fader, or AFL, after-fader? And there's a few other options here as well. So this is the monitor page on the X32 family of digital consoles. I hope you picked up some tips here. I'm John with Behringer, and thanks for joining us here at Music Group Studios.